Colonel McDonough, ladies and gentlemen, I have come to Germany to learn at first hand the problems involved in the reconstruction of Germany and to discuss with our representatives the views of the United States government as to some of the problems confronting us. We in the United States have given considerable time and attention to these problems because upon their proper solution will depend not only the future well-being of Germany, but the future well-being of Europe. Power and all the resources we possess. The American people want peace. They have long since ceased to talk of a hard or a soft peace for Germany. This never has been the real issue. What we want is a lasting peace. We will oppose harsh and vengeful measures which obstruct an effective peace. We will oppose soft measures which invite the breaking of the peace. In agreeing at Potsdam that Germany should be disarmed and demilitarized, and in proposing that the four major powers should by treaty jointly undertake to see that Germany is kept disarmed and demilitarized for a generation, the United States was not unmindful of the responsibility resting upon it and its major allies to maintain and enforce peace under all. Freedom from militarism will give the German people the opportunity, if they will but seize it, to apply their great energies and abilities to the works of peace. It will give them the opportunity to show themselves worthy of the respect and friendship of peace-loving nations, and in time, to take an honorable place among the members of the United Nations. It is not in the interest of the German people, or in the interest of world peace, that Germany should become a pawn or a partner in a military struggle for power between the East and the West. Twice in our generation, German militarism and Nazism have devastated the lands of Germany's neighbors. It is only fair and just that Germany should do her part to repair that devastation. Most of the victims of Nazi aggression before the war were less well off than Germany. They should not be expected by Germany to bear unaided the major costs of Nazi aggression. The United States, therefore, is prepared to carry out fully the principles outlined in the Potsdam Agreement on demilitarization and reparation. However, there should be changes in the levels of industry agreed upon by the Allied Control Commission if Germany is not to be administered as an economic unit as the Potsdam Agreement contemplates and requires. The basis of the Potsdam Agreement was that, as part of a combined program of demilitarization and reparation, Germany's war potential should be reduced by elimination and removal of her war industries and the reduction and removal of heavy industrial plants. It was contemplated this should be done to the point that Germany would be left with levels of industry capable of maintaining in Germany average European living standards without assistance from other countries. The plants sought to be removed were to be delivered as reparations to the Allies. The plants to be removed from the Soviet zone would go to the Soviet Union and Poland. And the plants to be removed from the Western zone would go in part to the Soviet Union, but in the main to the Western Allies. Provision was also made for the distribution of Germany's foreign assets among the Allies.
European.
The German people were not denied, however, the possibility of improving their lot by hard work over the years. Industrial growth and progress were not denied then, being obliged to start again, like the people of other devastated countries, with a peacetime economy not able to provide them more than the average European standard, the German people were not to be denied the right to use such savings as they might be able to accumulate by hard work and frugal living to build up their industries for peaceful purposes. That was the principle of reparations to which President Truman agreed at Potsdam. And the United States will not agree to the taking from Germany of greater reparations than was provided by the Potsdam Agreement. The carrying out of the Potsdam Agreement has, however, been obstructed by the failure of the Allied Control Council to take the necessary steps to enable the German economy to function as an economic unit. Essential central German administrative departments have not been established, although they are expressly required by the Potsdam Agreement. The equitable distribution of essential commodities between the several zones so as to produce a balanced economy throughout Germany and reduce the need for imports has not been arranged, although that too is expressly required by the Potsdam Agreement. The working out of a balanced economy throughout Germany to provide the necessary means to pay for approved imports has not been accomplished, although that too